This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Londinium was a settlement established on the current site of the city of London around AD. Resulted Londinium supported a smaller but stable settlement population, as archaeologists have found that much of the city after this date was covered in dark earth, the byproduct of urban household waste, manure, ceramic tile, and non-farm debris of settlement occupation, which accumulated relatively undisturbed for centuries sometime between 190 and 225. The Romans built a defensive wall around the landward side of the city along with Hadrian's Wall and the road network. This wall was one of the largest construction projects carried out in Roman Britain. The London Wall survived for another 1,600 years and broadly defined the perimeter of the old city of London, part of a series on the history of London, Roman London, Anglo-Saxon London, Norman and Medieval London, Tudor London, Stuart London, 18th century London, 19th century London, London 1900-39. London in World War II, Modern London from 1945, London in the 1960s. See also Timeline, London Portal, VE Contents, 1 Name, 2 Location, 3 Status, 4 History, 41 Founding, 42 Roads, 43 Boudicca, 44 First Century, 45 Port, 46 Second Century, 47 London Wall, 48 Third Century, 49 Carolingian Revolt, 410 Fourth Century, 411 Fifth Century, 5 Excavation, 6 Displays, 7 See also 8 Notes, 9 References, 10 Further Reading, 11 External Links. Name, Main Article, Etymology of London. The etymology of the name Londinium is unknown. Following Geoffrey of Monmouth's pseudo-historical History of the Kings of Britain, it was long derived from an eponymous founder named Lud, son of Heli. There is no evidence such a figure ever existed. Instead, the Latin name was probably based on a native Brittonic placename reconstructed as Londinian morphologically. This points to a structure of two suffixes. In Jo, however, the Roman Londinium was not the immediate source of English London, Old English, London, as I mutation would have caused the name to have been Linden. This suggests an alternative Brittonic form, Londinian. Alternatively, the local pronunciation in British Latin may have changed the pronunciation of Londinium to Londenu or Londian, which would also have avoided I mutation in Old English. The list of the 28 cities of Britain included in the 9th century History of the Britons precisely notes London in Old Welsh as Caer Lundum or Lundian. A map of Roman Britain. Location: the site guarded the Romans' bridgehead on the north bank of the Thames and a major road nexus. It centred on Cornhill and the River Walbrook, but expanded west to Ludgate Hill and east to Tower Hill just prior to the Roman conquest. The area had been contested by the Catavellauni based to its west and the Trinovantes based to its east. It bordered the realm of the Cantiaci on the south bank of the Thames. The Roman city ultimately covered at least the area of the city of London, whose boundaries are largely defined by its former wall. Londinium's waterfront on the Thames ran from around Ludgate Hill in the west to the present site of the tower in the east, around 15 kilometres. 093. Romano-British settlement. It had almost certainly been granted colony-colonia status prior to the complete replanning of the city's street plan attending the erection of the Great Second Forum around the year 120. By this time, Britain's provincial administration had also almost certainly been moved to Londinium from Camulodunum Colchester in Essex. The precise date of this change is unknown, and no surviving source explicitly states that Londinium was the capital of Britain, but there are several strong indications of this status. 2nd-century roofing tiles have been found marked by the procurator or publican of the province of Britain at Londinium. The remains of a governor's palace and tombstones belonging to the governor's staff have been discovered, and the city was well defended and armed, with a new military camp erected at the beginning of the 2nd century. Despite being far from any frontier, despite some corruption to the text, the list of bishops for the 314 Council of Arles indicates that either Restitutus or Adelphius came from Londinium. The city seems to have been the seat of the diocesan vicar and one of the provincial governors following the Diocletian reforms around the year 300. It had been renamed Augusta, a common epithet of provincial capitals, by 368. History founding. See also, Roman conquest of Britain. Prior to the arrival of the Roman legions, the area was almost certainly lightly rolling open countryside traversed by numerous streams now underground. No major Celtic settlement has been found at the site, but the city's Latin name now seems to have derived from an originally Brittonic one, and artifacts have been found showing that the hills of the London were frequented if not inhabited by small villages. Londinium grew up around the point on the River Thames, narrow enough for the construction of a Roman bridge but still deep enough to handle the era's seagoing ships. Its placement on the tideway permitted easier access for ships sailing upstream against the current. The remains of a massive pier base for such a bridge were found in 1981 close by the modern London Bridge. Some Claudian-era camp ditches have been discovered, but archaeological excavations undertaken since the 1970s by the Department of Urban Archaeology at the Museum of London, now MoLA's, have suggested the early settlement was largely the product of private enterprise. A wooden drain by the side of the main Roman road excavated at No. 1 Poultry has been dated by dendrochronology to AD. From across the empire and that local markets existed for such objects. A map of the known Roman road network, highlighting the routes included in the Antonin Itinerary Roads main article, Roman roads in Britain. Of the 15 British routes recorded in the 2nd or 3rd century Antonin Itinerary, 7 ran to or from Londinium. Most of these have been shown to have been initially constructed near time of the city's foundation around AD. Town from the bridgehead in a straight line to reconnect with its northern extension towards Vironconium Wroxeter and the legionary base at Diva Victrix Chester. The Great Road ran northeast across Old Ford to Camulodunum Colchester and thence northeast along Pye Road to Venta Isnorum Caister. St. Edmund Ermine Street ran north from the city to Lindum Lincoln and Eboricum York. The Devil's Highway connected Londinium to Caliva Silchester and its roads to points west over the bridges near modern Staines. A minor road led southwest to the city's main cemetery and the old routes to the ford at Westminster Staines Street to Noviomagus Chichester did not reach Londinium proper but ran from the bridgehead in the southern suburb at Southwark. These roads varied from 12 to 20. And Her Daughters by Thomas Thornycroft, 1860s, cast by his son in Gaul, probably via Londinium G. Archaeological evidence has been yet discovered. A model of London in 85-90 on display in the Museum of London, depicting the first bridge over the Thames. First century after being sacked, the city was rebuilt as a planned Roman town, its streets generally adhering to a grid skewed by major roads passing from the bridgehead and by changes in alignment produced by crossings over the local streams it recovered. After about a decade, a fortified enclosure was erected at Plantation Place on Cornhill. The first forum was constructed in the 70s or 80s and has been excavated, showing it had an open courtyard with a basilica and several shops around it, altogether measuring about 100. During the later decades of the first century, Londinium expanded rapidly and quickly became Roman Britain's largest city. Although most of its houses continued to be made of wood by the turn of the century, Londinium was perhaps as large as 60,000 people and had replaced Camulodunum Colchester as the provincial capital. A large building discovered near Cannon Street Station has had its foundation dated to this era and is assumed to have been the gubernatorial palace praetorium. It boasted a garden, pools, and several large halls, some of which were decorated with mosaic floors. It was located on the east bank of the now covered River Walbrook near its entrance to the Thames. Part of the structure, perhaps a portion the main entrance, is speculated to be the origin of the London Stone. Another site dating to this era is the Bath House Thermae at Huggin Hill, which remained in use prior to its demolition around the year 200. Brothels were legal but taxed. A diagram of the Roman structures from the port of Londinium CAD. Continued into the 3rd century, scraps of armor, leather straps, and military stamps on building timbers suggest that the site was constructed by the city's legionaries. Major imports included fine pottery, jewelry, and wine. Only two large warehouses are known, implying that Londinium functioned as a bustling trade center rather than a supply depot and distribution center like Ostia near Rome. A bronze head of Hadrian found in London British Museum. 2nd century Emperor Hadrian visited in 122. The impressive public buildings from around this period may have been initially constructed in preparation for his visit or during the rebuilding that followed the Hadrianic Fire. This fire, which archaeologists have discovered destroyed much of the city, is not recorded by any surviving source and seems to have occurred in a time of relative calm in Britain. For those reasons, it is generally assumed to have been accidental. A model of the expanded forum at the Museum of London during the early 2nd century, Londinium was at its height. London recovered from the fire and again had between 45,000 and 60,000 inhabitants around the year 140, with many more stone houses and public buildings erected. Some areas were tightly packed with townhouses. Domi, the town had piped water and a fairly sophisticated drainage system. The gubernatorial palace was rebuilt and an expanded forum was built around the earlier one over a period of 30 years from around 90 to 120 into an almost perfect square measuring 168. its own bath in addition to such structures reducing the city's building density. However, Londinium also seems to have shrunk in both size and population in the second half of the 2nd century. The cause is uncertain, but plague is considered likely, as the Antonine Plague is recorded decimating other areas of Western Europe between 165 and 190. The end of imperial expansion in Britain after Hadrian's decision to build his wall may have also damaged the city's economy, although Londinium remained important for the rest of the Roman period. No further expansion occurred. Londinium remained well populated, as archaeologists have found that much of the city after this date was covered in dark earth, one that accumulated relatively undisturbed for centuries. A surviving fragment of the London Wall behind Tower Hill Station. 2005 London Wall main article. London Wall sometime between 190 and 225. The Romans built the London Wall, a defensive ragstone wall around the landward side of the city along with Hadrian's Wall and the road network. The London Wall was one of the largest construction projects carried out in Roman Britain. The wall was originally about 5 tower west to Ludgate at about 1 mile 16. Ulpius Silvanus's Tauroctony depicting Mithras killing the bull, discovered in the ruins of the London Mithraeum. 3rd century Septimius Severus defeated Albinus in 197 and shortly afterwards divided the province of Britain into upper and lower halves, with the former controlled by a new governor in Eboricum York. Despite the smaller administrative area, the economic stimulus provided by the wall and by Septimius Severus's campaigns in Caledonia somewhat revived London's fortunes in the early 3rd century. The northwest fort was abandoned and dismantled, but archaeological evidence points to renewed construction activity from this period. The London Mithraeum rediscovered in 1954 dates from around 240, when it was erected on the east bank at the head of navigation on the now covered River Walbrook about 200. Carausian Revolt main article. Carausian Revolt in 286, the Emperor Maximian issued a death sentence against Carausius, admiral of the Roman Navy's Britannic fleet Classis Britannica, on charges of having abetted Frankish and Saxon piracy and of having embezzled recovered treasure. Carausius responded by consolidating his allies and territory and revolting after fending off Maximian's first assault in 288. He declared a new Britannic Empire and issued coins to that effect. Constantius Chlorus's sack of his Gallic base at Gesericum Boulogne, however, led his treasurer Electus to assassinate and replace him in 296. Chlorus mounted an invasion of Britain that prompted Electus's Frankish mercenaries to sack Londinium. They were only stopped by the arrival of a flotilla of Roman warships on the Thames, which slaughtered the survivors. The event was commemorated by the golden Trier medallion, Chlorus on one side and, on the other, a woman kneeling at the city wall welcoming a mounted Roman soldier. Another memorial to the return of Londinium to Roman control was the construction of a new set of forum baths around the year 300. The structures were modest enough that they were previously identified as parts of the forum and market, but are now recognized as elaborate and luxurious baths, including a frigidarium with two southern pools and an eastern swimming pool. 4th century. See also, Celtic Christianity and Bishops of Londinium following the revolt. The Diocletian reforms saw the British administration restructured. Londinium is universally supposed to have been the capital of one of them, but it remains unclear where the new provinces were, whether there were initially 3 or 4 in total, and whether Valentia represented a 5th province or a renaming of an older one in the 12th century. Gerald of Wales listed Londinia as the capital of Flavia, having had Britannia Prima Wales and Secunda Kent severed from the territory of Upper Britain. Modern scholars more often list Londinium as the capital of Maxima Caesariensis on the assumption that the presence of the diocesan vicar in London would have required its provincial governor to outrank the others. The gubernatorial palace and old large forum seem to have fallen out of use around 300, but in general the first half of the 4th century appears to have been a prosperous time for Britain, for the villa estates surrounding London appear to have flourished during this period. The London Mithraeum was rededicated, probably to Bacchus. A list of the 16 archbishops of London was recorded by Jocelyn of Furness in the 12th century, claiming the city's Christian community was founded in the 2nd century under the legendary king. Restitutus or Adelphius at the 314 Council of Arles seems to have come from Londinium. The location of Londinium's original cathedral is uncertain. The present structure of St. point that one of the existing provinces was renamed Valentia, although the account of Theodosius's actions describes it as a province recovered from the enemy in 382. Magnus Maximus organized all of the British-based troops and attempted to establish himself as emperor over the west. The event was obviously important to the Britons, as Maxin Wledig would remain a major figure in Welsh folklore, and several medieval Welsh dynasties claimed descent from him. He was probably responsible for London's new church in the 370s or 380s. He was initially successful but was defeated by Theodosius. Himself emperor over the west and crossed the Channel, an act considered the Roman withdrawal from Britain, since the emperor Honorius subsequently directed the Britons to look to their own defence rather than send another garrison force. Surviving accounts are scanty and mixed with Welsh and Saxon legends concerning Vortigern, Hengist, Horsa, and Ambrosius Aurelianus. Even archaeological evidence of Londinium during this period is minimal, despite remaining on the list of Roman provinces. Romano-Britain seemed to have dropped their remaining loyalties to Rome. Raiding by the Irish, Picts, and Saxons continued, but Gildas records a time of luxury and plenty which is sometimes attributed to reduced taxation. Archaeologists have found evidence that a small number of wealthy families continued to maintain a Roman lifestyle until the middle of the 5th century, inhabiting villas in the southeastern corner of the city. Medieval accounts state that the invasions that established Anglo-Saxon England, the Adventus Saxonum, did not begin in earnest until some time in the 440s and 450s. Bede recorded that the Britons fled to Londinium in terror after their defeat at the Battle of Creckanford, probably Crayford, but nothing further is said. By the end of the 5th century, the city was largely an uninhabited ruin, its large church on Tower Hill burnt to the ground. Over the next century, Angles, Saxons, Jutes, and Frisians arrived and established tribal areas and kingdoms. The area of the Roman city was administered as part of the Kingdom of the East Saxons, Essex, although the Saxon settlement of Londonich was not within the Roman walls but to the west in Aldwych. It was not until the Viking invasions of England that King Alfred the Great moved the settlement back within the safety of the Roman walls, which gave it the name Londonburh. The foundations of the River Wall, however, were undermined over time and had completely collapsed by the 11th century. Memory of the earlier settlement survived. It is generally identified as the Caer Lundum, counted among the 28 cities of Britain included in the History of the Britons, traditionally attributed to Nennius. A Romano-Celtic temple being excavated at 56 Gresham Street. Excavation. See also, Museum of London and Museum of London Archaeology. Many ruins remain buried beneath London, although understanding them can be difficult owing to London's own geology, which consists of a taplow terrace deep bed of brick earth, sand, and gravel over clay. Roman gravel roads can only be identified as such if they were repeatedly relayered or if the spans of gravel can be traced across several sites. The minimal remains from wooden structures are easy to miss, and stone buildings may leave foundations, but, as with the Great Forum, they were often dismantled for stone during the Middle Ages and early modern period. The known floor plan of the presumed Governor's Palace. The Roman Wall at St. Discovered in 1954, excavations of what was thought to have been an early church instead revealed the London Mithraeum, which was relocated to permit building over its original site. The building erected at the time has since been demolished, and plans to return the temple to its former location are underway. Archaeologists began the first intensive excavation of the waterfront sites of Roman London in the 1970s. What was not found during this time has been built over, making it very difficult to study or discover anything new. Another phase of archaeological work followed the deregulation of the London Stock Exchange in 1986, which led to extensive new construction in the city's financial district from 1991. Many excavations were undertaken by the Museum of London's Archaeology Service, although it was spun off into the separately run MOLA in 2011 following legislation to address the Rose Theatre fiasco. A reconstructed Roman kitchen coolina at the Museum of London 2014 displays major finds from Roman London, including mosaics, wall fragments, and old buildings were formerly housed in the London and Guildhall Museums. These merged after 1965 into the present Museum of London near the Barbican Centre. Museum of London Docklands, a separate branch dealing with the history of London's ports, opened on the Isle of Dogs in 2003. Other finds from Roman London continue to be held by the British Museum. Much of the surviving wall is medieval, but Roman-era stretches are visible near Tower Hill Station, in a hotel courtyard at 8-10 Cooper's Row, and in St. Latin Carat Geoffrey of Monmouth, translated by Ya Giles. Carat ABC Ford, David Nash. The 28 Cities of Britain at Britannia 2000. Carat AB Nennius Atrib Theodor Mommsen ed Historia Britannum, v. composed after A.D. Reprinted by the Perseus Project, C. 2011 hosted at Wikisource Carat A. B. Merrifield, pp. Quinum, et ex quibus provinces, ad aerolatensum synodum convenerent, the names of the bishops with their clerics who came together at the Synod of Arles and from which province they came, from the Concilia in Thackeray Carat A. B. living in Roman London, from Londinium to London, London, the Museum of London retrieved 17 February 2015. Carat ABCD Public Life, All Roads Lead to Londinium Museum of London Group retrieved 22 February 2015. Westminster, and the Saxon Ford was further upstream at Kingston against such doubts. Shepherd notes the known routes broadly direct towards Westminster in a way inconceivable if they were meant to be directed towards a ferry at Londinium and Merrifield points to routes directed towards the presumed ford from Southwark. Both include maps of the known routes around London and their proposed reconstruction of major connections now lost. Carat Rosam, Peter Chapter 2000 Heart of the City, Roman, Medieval, and Modern London revealed by archaeology at 1 Poultry Museum of London Archaeology Service p. Carat, Highbury, Upper Holloway and King's Cross, Old and New London, Volume 2 1878-273-279 Date accessed, 26 December 2007 Carat Merrifield, pp. Carat A. B. Brigham Carat A. B. C. Hall. Carat Lepage, Jean Denis G.G. 2012 British Fortifications Through the Reign of Richard III, An Illustrated History Jefferson, Macfarlane. Today, Riverside Wall, Museum of London Group retrieved 17 February 2015. Roman London. In Watson, Bruce Roman London, Recent Archaeological Work JRA Supplementary Series 24 Portsmouth, Re, Journal of Roman Archaeology pp.